which had an issue of blood 12 years, and had suffered many things of many physicians, and had spent all she had, and was nothing better, but rather grew worse. Verse 27, when she had heard of Jesus, somebody say, when she heard of Jesus, came in the press behind and touched his garment. For she said, if I may touch but his clothes, I shall be whole. And straightway the fountain of her blood was dried up, and she felt in her body, somebody say she felt in her body, that she was healed of that plague. And Jesus, immediately knowing in himself that virtue had gone out of him, turned him about in the press and said, who touched my clothes? And his disciples said unto him, thou seest the multitude thronging thee, and sayest thou, who touched me? And he looked round about to see her, somebody say her, that had done this thing. Verse 33. But the woman, fearing and trembling, knowing what was done in her, came and fell down before him, and told him all the truth. Somebody say all the truth. And said unto her, daughter, thy faith hath made thee whole. Go in peace and be whole of thy plague. Just one second. Father, we thank you for this day. We thank you for your love and mercy and kindness. Father, we pray now, God, that you will have, give us an ear to hear what the Spirit is saying unto the church. Father, we're praying now for each and every individual that's in this place, from the greatest to the least. Father, we have sometimes been stricken with issues for many, many years. But Father, but when we see Jesus, oh God, our situation will turn for our faith. And Father, we bless you now, and let the words of our mouth and the meditation of our heart, Father, let it be acceptable in thy sight. Oh Lord, our strength and my redeemer. In Jesus' name. Amen. You may be seated. Deacon Woods, if you would play the song.
He leads me beside still waters. Restoreth my soul. When you become a believer, the spirit is made right. Sometimes the soul doesn't get the notice. It has a hold in it due to things that's happened in the past, hurt, abuse, molestation. But we want to speak to you today and tell you that God wants to heal the whole of the soul. Some people's actions are not because their spirit is wrong, but it's because the past has left a hole in their soul. May this wisdom help you get over your past and remind you that God wants to heal the hole in your soul. I have my sister Leandria here. She's going to help me share this wisdom and tell this story.
All I seem to do is hurt me.
talk. Amen. When we pray, we want to end that with a declaration, a decree. So I'm speaking for all of you listening, starting here, starting now. The things that hurt you in the past will control your future.
Jesus said, I have come that you might have life and that he might have it
more abundant.
Therefore, it's our obligation to understand, in spite of how I feel, the word has already been declared that by his stripes
I'm
healed. So it's up to me now to declare what the word of God has already declared. Lord, I thank you. We have been in a place of complacency as the body of Christ. I preached on healing a couple of times before today. I talked about don't bruise the fruit. I came from the book of Galatians where it talks about the fruit of the Spirit. Love, joy, peace, happiness, long-suffering, temperance, meekness, kindness. All those fruit of the Spirit I talked about. And a lot of times, if you can picture it in your mind, bananas. The bruised one, you've been to the market. You see the one that's really, really bruised. You didn't want to pick up unless you make a banana pudding. And the ones that look really, really yellow, they look really, really good. God said that he sees the church with bruised. And I'm not talking about just read the Bible, I'm talking about the body of Christ. The bruised fruit, listen, God, I thank you. He says a bruise is an outward appearance with an inward effect. The Lord told me, not Western, not Meridian, not none of these Google, I didn't Google nothing, I didn't YouTube nothing. He says, Billy, a bruise is an outward appearance, watch this, with an inward effect. So then when you peel that bruised banana, what you've seen on the outside is on the inside. But the ripe banana being a heal, being healed, being healing, what the way you see it on the outside, that's what you do when you peel it.
You preach it.
So therefore, when God says, when I'm looking at my church, all I'm seeing is a bunch of bruised fruit. He therefore said, it's up to us, amen, to help heal the broken heart.
Amen.
His word has already decreed it. So we must declare it in our lives. So then when we start, amen, talking about one another, not being on one accord, getting in our cliques, gossiping, we're bruising the fruit. Y'all are fruit. I'm fruit. We're that banana, so to speak. Stay with me. I'm going somewhere. And he says, and we all say, hurt people, but guess what? Heal people.
Heal people.
Heal people.
Come on now. Come on.
We often declare, hurt people, but baby, heal people. Even as our soul prospers. understand how important it is for us and our soul to prosper. Once our soul prospers, and once we're in the Word of God, health comes. Did not the scriptures declare that seek ye first the kingdom of God?
Amen.
And his righteousness and all these other things shall be added unto us. This lady, stricken with an issue of blood, because we have some children in here, I won't go into too much detail, but she was bleeding for 12 long years.
Amen.
She had to deal with society. She had to deal with folk talking about her. She had to deal with folk not getting close to her.
Amen.
Have you ever been in a place where it sounded like you were all alone? Nobody cared about what you were going through. Nobody cared about what you were dealing with. That's your problem. You deal with it. But how many know that we are a body that's fitly joined together? We got to look beyond what I'm going through and what I'm dealing with. And we gotta help that other person.
All right.
Get to Jesus.
All right.
Stop preparing to die just because you felt funny. Stop preparing to die just because the doctor said you ain't gonna live. Stop preparing to die just because, amen, your mind is playing tricks on you. Amen. Stop preparing to die because you don't know what's going on.
Come on, man.
Stop preparing to live. Declare the word of the Lord. Say that I'm going to live, but I'm not going to die. But I might declare the works of the Lord in the land that I'm living. I have just been healed to say God did it. And I've been healed because I need to work in the kingdom. We a lot of times want to get our healings, amen, so we can go back to what we were doing prior. But we got to learn how to understand that when God healed, I gotta get to work for the kingdom of God. Put your hands together and give God a praise. My brothers and sisters, we don't look down on each other long enough. We didn't backbite long enough. We've been talking about each other long enough. We need to be healed. He said, it's my people. But you call them by name. Amen. We ain't made subject like a building of our most holy faith, God. Praying in the Holy Ghost. We got to know how to build up our spiritual immune system. Because all this junk and mess is going on in the world. God, I thank you. But when you stay before God, when you seek God, you're building up your immune system that you can withstand the enemy.
Amen.
Test and try. God, I thank you when they come at you. Amen. Can you clap and give God praise? I hope you're totally understanding the importance of being healed. It's important for us, saints of God, to be healed. Delivered and set free. God has done too much for us. Amen. You don't think that he went to Calvary just because he didn't have nothing better to do. Well, the scripture declared that he who knew no sin became sin for us, that we might become the righteousness of God in Christ Jesus. God, I thank you for your word. That amen, that he hung and bled it down. Oh, he had nothing to say. He wouldn't finish there. But he went down to hell. They got the keys. And they said, all power is given unto me, both in heaven and in earth. God, I thank you. Oh, God, I thank you for healing. Healing is not just for you. Amen. To boast about. Amen. How good you look. How good you feel. How good you did this. Or how good you did that. Every time they make me wake up. And your body is healed. You ought to give God glory. You ought to give God praise. Of the very thing that attacks somebody else could attack you. We're not exempt. Just because we got the Holy Ghost. He reigns on the just and the unjust. There's been sinners healed. And there's been saints healed. Situation. Shit! Oh. She came!